His approval rating, when he came into office last year, he was around 60% and even more, and now he's around 40% and sometimes less. Who does he blame now, Putin, Trump, or you? The communication
team. Oh, does he blame me? Oh, I don't know. I hope not. Look.
So I don't know if that comment was like meant to be a joke or whatever, but like the idea that Joe Biden's overall approval rating, that the Democrats' overall approval rating has dropped for any of those reasons, just because of Vladimir Putin, or the most comical one perhaps, just because of Jen Psaki, like that shows such an unserious approach and a lack of respect, honestly, for the voters to think that they would be duped into turning on a politician just because they didn't like a spokesperson. No, there are very legitimate reasons why people are incredibly frustrated with Joe Biden, his administration, and the Democrats more broadly. And we're gonna get into it because Dan, you provided this awesome breakdown of a focus group. So tell me a little bit about why you wanted to talk about this topic.
Well, the first thing, and sorry to do some old school Dan producing here, but Skip, I want to go to the first graphic here, is I found this story in Politico Playbook this morning. And one of the highlights of this, the entire Politico Playbook thing is presented by Amazon. Unfortunately, just take into the entire context that Politico is providing this and Amazon is creating advertising for this. And keep in mind, you know, Amazon is in the world of union busting and trying to prevent people like Christian Smalls from having a voice in their workforce. But the funny thing about this is you're finally confronted with a situation where Democrats in the Beltway, inside of their bubble, like John was saying, have to realize that, oh no, there are actual reasons, material reasons that people don't like the Democratic Party. And it has nothing to do with whatever's going on in Ukraine. In fact, as you'll show, people are not really caring about that. What people are more interested in are material issues. The fact that the cost of food and gas is going up. Sometimes people blame the administration, sometimes they don't. People are tired and cynical of politics overall. And they believe that Joe Biden has failed to deliver on promises. Things that people in independent media have been saying till they're blue in the face, but things that Politico this morning went, whoa, look at that. We just got a focus group. And it turns out people are really upset about Joe Biden not delivering on promises. Mm-hmm. Wow. Oh my God. It's
like, please go into it. We've crunched the numbers and it looks like people want politicians to deliver. And honestly, I don't know what to do with this information. but let's make sure as we dive into this that you do not miss that Dan is right. We've been identifying this, but let's also be clear. We warned them about this way before they did it. They didn't have to do this. We warned pre-Biden administration that this was likely to be the path that they went down. And so if we were gonna be stuck with Biden, let's at least try to avoid this incredibly unsurprising outcome. But no, they're walking right into it. And so Politico is all shocked. They're like, Democrats are desperately trying to understand what's roiling the electorate heading into a brutal midterm environment. You don't know. You don't know. Anyway, the HIT strategies did these focus groups. And they're focus groups, by the way, of groups that are by definition very likely to continue to support Democrats or predisposed to. Black base, always vote for Democrats, 25 up. Youth base, always vote for Democrats, age 25 to 39. And what are some of the things that they cite in these focus groups? Oh, you know, shocking things like a preoccupation with inflation and crime. They don't like the inflation. They think there's a lot of crime. Exhaustion with pandemic restrictions. I get it. I don't think the restrictions have been what they could have been, but it's been a long time, so I get it. Cynicism about politics. Well, gee, I wonder why. And we'll stop with deep frustration that President Joe Biden and Democrats have failed to deliver on their early promises. Like, I get that we progressives are not gonna get the candidate we want. We're not getting the legislation or the executive orders we want. Can we at least get a consolation prize of credit for having predicted this years in advance? That this is how it's gonna go? That if you don't deliver, people are gonna be mad at you, and there will also be growing cynicism about politics. You can see it. You can see it in, you know, some of the media that people choose to pursue these days. That's, you know, very outside of politics at this point. Dan, so it's just, this is so unsurprising.
It's sickeningly unsurprising. And even the parts of it that are kind of, you know, left lean, not like kind of like more center leaning, like There's one aspect of ambiguity about how important the January 6th issue should be for Democrats in the midterms. Mm-hmm. I think that's aspect of Republican messaging and how much that wins. And yeah, sympathy from Ukraine mixed with a lack of enthusiasm for Biden spending too much time and money on the issue.
Yep.
I think it goes to an emphasis on, of course, people care and they're humans deep down and they look at these situations in Ukraine with tragedy and horror. But every day for people in America is sometimes tragedy and horror. Like, there are things that aren't being addressed at home that aren't being talked about by people in news pundits, of course, not independent media, but in big cable news all the time. And then regular things that people deal with every day are seen with vast surprise by these kind of pundits. So I think it just shows that when you pierce through the Beltway bubble, it shows how little they go onto the news every single day and talk to regular people.
Yeah. Yeah, 100%. Now, this is one of the rare opportunities where they can. A typical response came from a young white woman from Montana. Quote, "I think Democrats have just been really ineffectual." Yes. Shift that very slightly to feckless, and you have pretty much everything Anna's said for the last year and a half, basically at this point. One black female participant said she didn't feel much urgency about the midterms because at this moment, the Democrats are running the House and they're not getting much done. That's the thing. It's not that this is a massive threat that tons of Biden voters are going to start supporting Louis Gohmert or whatever. That's not the threat here. The threat is people feeling like, we did what you wanted us to do, man. We organized, we overcame so much voter suppression. We got people out there to vote. We gave you the White House after giving you the House, and we then gave you the Senate too. What more do you want out of us? And if you're not doing anything, they're not going to necessarily switch over to the Republicans, but are they going to be eager? Now, it might be that you need more support. I don't know. You can make whatever case you want, but you're hardly going about it in a way that's guaranteed to get people excited to vote. So I don't know. I'm glad that you brought this to my attention, Dan. It's not surprising, but it's a warning. As if the Democrats need any more, you are walking straight towards a cliff and you don't have to.
Super last thing. At this point, the only chance the Democrats have in the midterms, I think, is a Hail Mary of executive orders that Biden does near the midterms, close enough to where it's in people's memory, where it's like, okay, we're addressing student debt relief. Okay, we're addressing the voting rights reform that we want to do in whatever way you can through executive order. I think that's the only way you can get people's attention and motivate people to go, okay, Joe Biden's actually serious for not being the third term of the Obama administration, where obstructionist Republicans ruled the day until they actually ruled the day. So I think that's the only hope right now.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.